Hey guys, I'm back with another daily update video. It is Sunday, July 5th. It's about midday and just getting together my possible plays for this coming week, just my thoughts. And we just are in the middle of a long weekend. So Monday morning tomorrow is going to be interesting. I'm very curious to see what the futures are going to look like this evening and more importantly, what they're going to look like tomorrow morning. And I think that's really going to impact if I make any plays and if so, what plays I make. If we open up red tomorrow morning pre-market, I may hold off depending on if I think it's going to be like a big sell-off week or big sell-off day. But again, I'm just going to have to keep my plays fluid. But some of the stocks I'm looking at possibly trading this week are kind of my go-tos, where if you follow my videos for the past few weeks, I've had good success with these stocks, and they're the semiconductors like AMD and Micron. And then I've also had good success with IWM, just because it's the Russell 2000 ETF. And also, it seems as though IWM fluctuates a lot when the Fed prints money. So I feel like IWM is one of those stocks that the Fed is monitoring. And I know IWM is not a stock, it's an ETF, but just for the sake of argument, I call it a stock. It's just one of those tickers that the Fed seems to keep an eye on and almost regulate. Because anytime IWM drops pre-market or after hours, it seems to always get pumped up by the time the market opens. So I like IWM right now as well. It is on the pricier side, obviously, compared to AMD and Micron, but like I said, in the past, it served me well. And if you follow my latest videos, you know that right now I'm all cash. So if I were to open up positions on any of these tickers, they would be cash secured puts. So let's just take a look at AMD right now. So AMD had a pretty solid week. Let's look at the graph on Robinhood. So, you know, it dipped a little bit on June 26th over the weekend and into the morning, but then rallied up high during the week and then traded sideways. So AMD, if you follow my other videos, it looks like it loves to trade in this range of the low to high 50s. I mean, you can see this blue Fibonacci level here between roughly $50.88 and roughly $55, let's just say. Let's just say between 50 and 55. You can see over the past few weeks and months, AMD loves trading in that range. There's times when it's gone above, stayed there for a little bit, and then comes right back down. There's times where it's gone below. And you can see each of the three times, all the way dating back to May 1st, every time it's dipped below $50, within the next day or two, it's always bounced right back up above 50. So I feel like if you can get in a cash secured put below $50 on AMD, even if you get assigned those shares, chances are AMD stock price is going to rally, and then you can either sell covered calls or just sell the stock outright and get profit. So I really like AMD right now. If you follow my videos for the past week or so, you know I haven't played AMD in a while. So I might look into getting into some, at least one or maybe more positions of AMD if the market looks favorable tomorrow pre-market and then right when the market opens. So let's just take a quick look at some of the premiums that are on AMD. And I know this is gonna change when the market opens because this is from Thursday's data. So we've had 3 days for the market to react. But I would sell weeklies expiring July 10th, which is this coming Friday. And a lot of people ask me in my comments and also message me on Reddit in terms of how I decide which stocks to play. And if you've seen, I've created a video a few weeks or maybe even a month ago now about how I've created my watch list. So I'd recommend you go back and watch that. But I have a watch list of about, let's say, 15 stocks that I like to trade on because those are just companies and stocks that I like. And from that list, I pare it down every weekend basically and figure out which stocks or tickers I want to play. And one of the things I look at in terms of determining whether that ticker is giving me good premium or if one ticker is giving me better premiums than another is all you have to do, because Robinhood doesn't show you this data, but if you use other platforms like Thinkorswim or Schwab, maybe they probably show you this data if you search for it. But what you can do as a quick and dirty method to determine which one of your stickers or stocks are giving you good premiums is just look at the at the money option. So if we're going to sell a put, right, because we don't have any open contracts on AMD for right now, just look at the at-the-money put, which is the $52 strike, because AMD is trading at a little over 52, 52.32, and just calculate the return on risk. So this return on risk would be $101, right, because it's $1.01 per share, and every contract is 100 shares, so it's $101 divided by your collateral. which is going to be $5,200, right? Again, because it's $52 per share times 100 shares, so divided by 5,200. So the return on risk there, and we can multiply this by 100 to make it a percent, is 1.9%. So if we just want to write that down, and I'll write it in blue off to the side just so we have it. So that was 1.9%. I'll write AMD, and the at the money option was a 1.9% return on risk. So people like to, I know Thinkorswim likes to breathe this ROR, return on risk. So we'll just keep that in mind. And that's one way to determine roughly how good the premiums are. So now let's compare to another stock that I was looking at. So let's say I was looking at Micron as well. So we'll type in MU, the ticker for Micron. And Micron had a similar week. I mean, Micron had a giant pop off of its earnings on Monday, and then it slowly bled off. I'm sure a good part of this was profit taking, because Micron jumped from around 48.60 all the way to 52 and some change. So it popped a few bucks overnight. So that was some really quick and easy profits if you had Micron shares. And then immediately right after, when that market opened the next day, it slowly started bleeding off. Like I said, probably due to profit taking. But actually, when Micron popped, it took all of the other semiconductor stocks with it. They all rallied after hours and then all opened up higher the next day. But this is another stock I'm looking at. But you may be saying to yourself, well, you can play Micron and AMD because they're two different companies, but they're within the same sector. So if you want to diversify your money in terms of your options plays, it might not be smart, depending on how you want to look at it, to play both AMD and Micron at the same time. Now, if you think the semiconductor sector in general is very bullish, then it would make sense, because now you have two different companies in the same sector, so you have a little bit of diversity there, but it's not as diverse as if you were to play, let's say, Disney and AMD. So let's take a look at Micron's options. So again, we're going to sell a put, because we don't have any options open. And again, let's just take a look at the at-the-money option. So that will be $84 divided by $49.50. So what is the return on? So the return on risk on Micron is only 1.7% at the money. So we'll write that down. So we're going to write MU 1.7%. And again, I know the Thinkorswim platform will calculate this for you if you want. It's in the settings section. And you can add that to your watch list for your stock monitoring page. And so as you can see, just by comparing AMD and Micron, already I know that in general, currently, or at least as of last Thursday, AMD has a little bit better premiums than Micron for roughly the same degree of risk. So the at the money option for Micron has a 67.28% chance of profit. So let's go back to AMD to see what AMD is. So just remember 67.28. If you go to AMD's option chain again, we can see that for selling a put, AMD has a 66.9% chance of profit. So a little bit less, right, which is accounted for because you have a high return on risk, but it's not that much, right? So same thing. Everything in options trading is a risk to reward ratio. So if you want low risk, you're going to have to accept a lower reward. If you want a higher reward, you're going to have to accept a higher risk. But this is an idea of comparing two different stocks that you may be between playing options on one or the other. And as long as you're okay with a roughly 1% less chance of profit, you're gaining 0.2% return on your risk. And like I said, it's not much of a difference, but it's a difference between $101 for at the money on AMD and going back to the options change for Micron in terms of selling a put, $84 for Micron. So $101 minus 84. So it's a difference of $17 in max profit. Now granted, the strike prices of AMD and Micron are also different. But if you're just worried about total gains, like let's say you have a benchmark of, you know, personally you want to make $100 every week. That's just kind of your baseline benchmark, or that's your goal for every week. Well, the Micron play might not be great for you because you're below your benchmark. Whereas the AMD play, you're actually a dollar above it. So that's why options trading is very individualized and very personalized. But that's kind of that's the thought process that I go through in my head in terms of figuring out which one of my tickers I want to play for that week. And that's not the only factor, it's just one of the factors. So IWM had a good rally all week long, right? It slowly trickled up And if we take a look at the options chain on IWM, again, in terms of selling a put, if we want to look at the at the money option. So IWM is going to be $259 for the premium at the money. See, 259. We're going to divide it by 14,250 for 100 shares. And then we're going to get a return on risk times 100 of 1.81%. So 1.8%. So you can see based on those three tickers, right now AMD is actually giving me the best return on risk. Or you can estimate roughly that AMD has the best premiums compared to the other two stocks, all things being equal. So I just use this as a very quick and dirty method in terms of figuring out which one of my plays are going to be the most efficient in terms of my strategy. Now, if we take a look at some of these hype stocks or some of these meme stocks, their return on risk are going to be out of this world. No pun intended that I'm looking at space. But let's look at the SPC. So they recently, within the past week or two, signed a contract with NASA. So their price actually jumped a little bit. But if we take a look at the same calculation for space, it's probably going to be much higher than the other three stocks because it's got a lot of hype behind it. It's got a lot of volatility. So $45 divided by 1600 for 100 shares. You can see the return on risk for space is almost double, or actually a little less than double, any of these three stocks. So 2.8%. So if we want to write that down, let's just put that in orange. So space is 2.8%. So if you're just chasing dollars, then out of these four options, space is going to be your best selection because it's going to be the most efficient in terms of you making the most money. It has the highest reward. But likewise, you can see that it also has the highest risk because space is has not a very long-standing established company. It's relatively new. And you can see if you look at the stock price, it fluctuates a decent amount up and down. I mean, you can just see in the past 3 months here, it's increased 25%. In the past month, it's actually up 3%. But you can see these big swings up and down from a low of roughly $14.46 to highs of roughly $17. So it moves up and down by a range of roughly $3 just in the past month. And that might not seem like a lot, but the stock is only worth roughly $15. So a $3 price change in a $15 stock, that means that this stock is fluctuating like 20% roughly. So just keep that in mind. So if you have a profit goal every week, this would be a good way for you to kind of figure out which tickers you want to play to achieve that profit goal. But I wouldn't necessarily chase the specific dollar amounts unless you need to, meaning you're using this as a supplemental source of income. And let's say your car payments are $100 every week, and so you need to make that $100. Well, you can use this strategy. But I'm more concerned about efficiently making gains and efficiently making profits. So a lot of people have asked me, but I personally use a goal of 0.4% per week as my kind of baseline in terms of my return on risk assessment. So every week, let's just say, whatever your portfolio value is, so if your portfolio value is $10,000, and let's say I set a baseline of I want to make 0.4% on my week minimum, otherwise the trade is not worth it to me, then that means that if you want to take $10,000, so what's 0.4% of that? You're going to multiply by 0.004, so that's $40 a week. So that means that every week my goal is to make a profit of $40. Now that might not seem like a lot, but it adds up over time, because if you can do $40 a week consistently times 52 weeks, that's $2,080. Now again, that might not seem like a lot over a year, but remember, you only started with $10,000. If I divide that by 10,000 and not assuming compound interest, that's a return on your money of roughly 21% for the whole year. That's much better than any bank account. That's actually better than the historical average for the S&P 500. Over the past 90 years, the S&P 500 has returned on average, I believe, 9.8%. So let's just call it 10%. So you have doubled the average return of SPY or the S&P 500. So just think about that. Don't get caught up in the dollar value. I focus more on the percent value, the percent gain. And that way, it doesn't matter if you have a small account or a large account. Because if you can make money with a $10,000 account, then you can make the same money with a $10 million account, right? It doesn't make any difference. Because if you can make this transaction work for you, then you can make this transaction work for you, 10 million, right? Because all you have to do is just multiply whatever you're doing. And just to give you an idea, what would be 0.4% of 10 million? So 10 million, 1, 2, 3, times 0.004, it's gonna be $40,000 a week, okay? That's craziness. But think about it this way, because all you, let's just say you put on one trade, you sell one contract to make this $40, all you have to do is multiply that. So instead of selling one contract, sell 1,000 contracts. Because again, if you can make this money with a small account, you just have to multiply it and buy more contracts, and you can make the same amount of money with a larger account, or I should say the same percent of money. So that's my plan for this week. All in all, I'm gonna feel it out, see what the pre-market trading looks like tomorrow morning. And I'm probably looking at getting into AMD and maybe some IWM right now, because they give me the best premiums as of right now. They also look like they'd be relatively safe plays in my opinion right now, but again, things could change. So let me know what your plan is for this coming trading week. As always, if you have any questions or comments, leave them below, and happy trading.